Hello everyone, welcome to a new video with Dr. Solomon delivering renal and transplant bullets straight to your brain. Ever wondered how to write excellent, stunning, impressive assessment and plan? Well, relax, listen, and let's get started. I'll go over a framework or skeleton of how your assessment and plan should look like. In other words, what items do we include in the assessment and plan? So here's an example how to start your assessment. This is a 24-year-old African-American female presented on 1/3/2019 with fever and diarrhea. We were consulted for AKI management. See, we included the age, race, day and cause of admission, and reason for the consult. Then comment on 8 important items with the following mnemonic: Kelly and Ellie bringing Victoria along all corners. Kelly and Ellie bringing Victoria along all corners. K for kidney functions. A for acid base. E for electrolytes. B for blood pressure. V for volume. A for anemia. A for albumin or BMI. C for CKD MVD. Kelly and Ellie bringing Victoria along all corners. So starting with number 1, kidney function. If this is an AKI or CKD case, mention the last known baseline creatinine and when was that, then the trend and the most recent one. Comment on the urine output, urine analysis, and renal ultrasound. This is the hey, what's up of any kidney problem. Then put your differential diagnosis. Please document your way of thinking to benefit the primary team and the patient. Also, to justify your billing, remember, you get paid for what you think and your plan of management. In other words, address team's concerns. So this is an example: non-oliguric AKI on CKD3, baseline creatinine 2 on 1/3/2019, admitted on 1/6/2019 with a creatinine of 3. UA is bland with no proteinuria, renal ultrasound unremarkable, working differential diagnosis. And then you can document your way of thinking. If it's an ESRD case, don't forget the CC. Obtain a consent for dialysis and call the dialysis unit to get the dialysis run sheet. Then add the following 8 items to your note: axis cause complications, days dry wait, urinate, and 2 names, nephrologist and unit. Again, axis cause complications, days dry wait, urinate, and 2 names, nephrologist and unit. So axis, is it an AV fistula, AV graft, or PD catheter? What's the cause of renal failure? Any complications like fibrin in bags, pain around the catheter side, any hypotension on hemodialysis? What are the days of dialysis? What's the dry weight and the typical UF? Is the patient still making urine? Finally, the name of the nephrologist and the unit where the patient dialyzes. Axis cause complications, days dry weight, urinate, and 2 names, nephrologist and unit. If the patient is on PD, ask about the PD prescription. 1 number, 2 additives, 3 volume, type and time. 1 number, 2 additives, 3 volumes, type and time. 1 number, which are the cycles, how many cycles does the patient do? 2 additives, does he add insulin or heparin to the bags? 3 volumes, what's the total volume, what's the dwell volume, what's the midday exchange volume? Type of bags, red bags 4.25 dextrose, green bags 2.5% dextrose, or yellow bags 1.5% dextrose. Then the total time. Again, 1 number, 2 additives, 3 volumes, type and time. From the beginning, axis cause complications, days dry weight, urinate, and 2 names, nephrologist and unit. If it's a kidney transplant case, remember to add 8 items with the mnemonic KDPI. I will not go into details and definitions in this lecture, but will explain those later in detail. Remember, this is only a framework of how to write an assessment and plan. So KDPI, K for KDPI, kidney donor profile index and cause. KDPI and cause. D for day of transplant and donor-specific antibodies if previously checked. P for panel-reactive antibodies and previous biopsy. I for infectious disease, which includes CMV, PGP, fungal, and BK. And immunosuppression, which includes induction and maintenance immunosuppression. So again, K for KDPI and cause. D for day of transplant and DSAs. P for PRA and previous biopsy. I for infectious disease and immunosuppression, which include induction and maintenance. Moving on to the plan, be very precise, concise, efficient, and to the point. Example, place a Foley catheter, strict I's and O's, daily weight, stop ACE inhibitors, Start half normal saline plus 75 milliequivalents of bicarb at rate of 75 cc per hour. No emergent indication for dialysis. Recommendations to the primary team should be very clear, and don't let them get lost reading through your entire note. That's it. Thanks for listening. If you have any other suggestions or ideas, please leave them down in the comments below. If you liked this video, don't forget to hit like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Take care and see you soon.